Hello, welcome to the English class, children. Dear children, I hope you remember that we were doing chapter 4, The Enemy. We had seen that in spite of knowing that the white man belonged to the US Navy, Hannah and Siddhav decide to take him in and treat him. And once he became normal and healthy, they would hand him over to the police. This was their decision. But one problem that was torturing their mind, and it was a question in fact, and that question was, how would they convince the servants? Okay, that was the question in their mind. And we see that they decide that they are going to convince the servants in one way or the other, and at last they take him in. Hannah doesn't want to give the quilt, remember, the blanket which is covered with silk and all. Yeah, so she never wanted to give the quilt because the quilt was very beautiful. But then she says the man is very dirty. So that is when Siddhav realizes that the man needs to be cleaned up. So he says if Hannah could get some hot water, he could clean the man. But then Hannah says she cannot think about or imagine about him touching or even cleaning this man. So she said she would inform Yumi and ask her to clean this man up. Yumi, who is Yumi? Yeah, Yumi is their nanny, the nanny of the children, the caretaker of the children. Okay, they have two children, one boy and a girl. So Yumi is a caretaker of these children. Okay, so today, children, I think yesterday we stopped at that, last class. So today we are going to start with page 30, paragraph 4. I hope all of you are ready for it. Okay. She turned to the nursery and called Yumi. Who is she here? Hannah. Hannah turns to the nursery. Nursery? Yeah, where the babies are kept. Okay, the room of the babies. It's known as nursery. So Hannah turns towards the nursery and calls for Yumi. But the children heard her voice, and she had to go in for a moment and smile at them and play with the baby boy, now nearly 3 months old. So actually, if the mothers are away from the children for a long time, they just long for the mother. Whoever, whatever comfort you give a child, but if the mother is not near, the child won't be that happy. Okay, so that's why here you see this particular child. Okay, she the children hear her voice when she calls out for Yumi, and Hannah is forced to go into the nursery and play with the baby boy who is 3 years old. And the baby boy was reluctant to accept any comfort from Yumi. So Hannah had to go in. Okay. Over the boy's soft black hair, she motioned with her mouth. Yumi, come with me. So she took the baby boy, she motioned the baby boy's hair. She motioned her face on baby boy's hair. Okay, and then she asks Yumi to follow her, come with her. I will put the baby to bed. I'll put the baby to bed means the baby is about to sleep. I'll make him sleep in the bed. Yumi replied, he is ready. He is ready means he's almost slept. Means he has almost slept. So now I'll put him in the bed. She went with Yumi into the bedroom next to the nursery and stood with the boy in her arms, while Yumi spread the sleeping quilts on the floor and laid the baby between them. So Yumi, what did she do? She went to the nursery. She laid the bed properly for the baby to sleep. She made the baby sleep in the quilt laid on the floor and then laid the baby between them. That is, them between the quilts. Then Hannah led the way quickly and softly to the kitchen. The two servants were fighting at what their master had told them. So the other two servants, who are the other two servants? The cook and the gardener. So when Yumi was informed, till now Yumi is not informed, just Hana is told that she had to do some work, and that's why Hana was calling her. But here Sadao had already informed the servants that they had a white man in the house, and they were fighting on that topic. The old gardener, who was also a house servant, pulled few hairs on his upper lip, mustache. The hair on the upper lip is a mustache. So he pulled few hair off his upper lip, and this pulling of the hair of the upper lip, it shows in some people, it's a kind of it's a way to express the tension and the anxiety that is there in them. Okay, so here the old gardener was totally tensed up and he was anxious. What next? Okay, that was the anxiety in him. The master ought not to heal the wound of this white man, he said bluntly to Hana. Bluntly, without any, without hiding, openly, frankly. Okay, so Hana, and this gardener told Hana frankly that the master, who is the master? Sadao. Sadao should not heal. Heal means cure. Okay, cure the wound of this white man. Why? Because the white man is ought to die. First he was shot, then the sea caught him and wounded him with her rocks. If the master heals, what the gun did and what the sea did, they will take revenge on us. So see, this is where we see lack of education. An educated man will never say that gun and sea, they are taking their revenge, or they don't want this man to live. Okay, in fact, if he is an educated person, he would say, in spite of a gunshot, in spite of having such wounds in the sea, he is still alive. That shows that he is supposed to be alive. Okay, God wants him to be alive. That's why he had brought this man to the shore. This is the concept that an educated person would think about. But here, it's not like that. Here, this man is saying that this man who is illiterate, the gardener, he is saying that no, it's not like that. This person should not be cured by our master, because he was what, first shot by a gun, and then the sea caught him and wounded him with a spiky rocks. Okay, and now if the master healed him or cured him, then the gun and the sea would take their revenge. Is it possible? No, it's not possible. It's just an illiterate man's ideas. It can never happen. I will tell him what you say, Hana replied courteously. So very courteously, she knew the situation. She could understand the situation that they are in trouble. And if she shouted at them, the situation would go the other way around. So she kept very calm. She said to the gardener that she would inform whatever they said, she would say that to her husband. But she herself was also frightened, although she was not superstitious as the old man was. Now, but Hana was also frightened. Why was she frightened? Remember, in the beginning, last day we talked about it, her fright, that if they don't hand him over to the police, then the family would be in danger, Sadao's job would be in danger. Okay, so this was the concept that was haunting Hana. What do you mean by haunting? Disturbing. In this context, it's disturbing. Haunting has another meaning also. I would love you to find out what is the another meaning for haunting. Okay, so this particular concept that they would be in danger if they don't hand him over, or if someone finds out that there is a white man, and that too who is a prisoner of war in their house. Okay, then everything would become a big means everything would be destroyed. Their life, their house, their Sadao's job, everything. But she was not scared of all the superstitious belief that old man was talking about. Could it ever be well to help an enemy? So this was another question. Was it right on their part to help an enemy? Was it right? Nevertheless, she told Yumi to fetch hot water and bring it to the room where the white man was. So, okay, there's no way out. Her husband had commanded her to bring hot water. So she went to Sadao's, she asked Yumi to bring some hot water to the room where the white man was. She went ahead and slid back the partition. Partition means the door, okay, that was there. So she just slid back the partitions where the white man was. Okay, Sadao was not yet there. Yumi, following, put down her wooden bucket. Then she went over to the white man. When she saw him, her thick lips folded themselves into stubbornness. Stubbornness. So what happened? Yumi was following Hana. They went into the room. Till then, Yumi never knew what was happening all around. Sadao, he was not there in the room. And when Yumi came in, she placed the bucket down, wooden bucket down, and then went near the white man. And when she saw the white man, her thick lips folded into stubbornness. That is, that anger, that feeling, okay, that irritation, everything could be seen on her face. Okay, she was not happy seeing this white man in the house. Okay, I have never washed a white man, she said, and I will not wash so dirty a one now. So Yumi says, in my whole life, I've never washed or cleaned up a white man. And now, today also, I'm not going to clean up a white man as dirty as this one. Okay, he's not going to do it. Hana cried at her severely. You will do what your master commands you. So Hana shouts. Okay, she is also irritated at the sight of this white man. She also never wanted, but there was no way out. They had to bring him in. Okay, that is the humane quality that was there in them. Okay, so she says that Hana just shouts at this Yumi. She says, you have to do what your master commands you to do. Who is the master? Again, Sadao. Okay. There was so fierce a look of resistance upon Yumi's round, dull face that Hana felt unreasonably afraid. So there was a look, a fierce look on her, on Yumi's face. Okay, that she is not going to do it. Okay, not going to wash this man. And this look made Hana unreasonably afraid. Afraid of what? That things might become difficult for them. Okay, she was unreasonably. There may be some reason, there may not be some reason, but somewhere Hana was scared at that look of Yumi. After all, if the servants should report something that was not as it happened, suppose these servants went out and informed the police that there was a white man in their house, and they say that they are trying to help a white man, or they are helping the Americans. It was not like that. And suppose such a thing happens, what would happen? Things would be very difficult. Okay, that is, they might lose their life. They might lose, Sadao might lose his job. their such a sweet family might be disturbed. So this was the fear that was there in Hannah's heart. Okay, children, today we'll stop here. Tomorrow we'll continue from the portion where we stopped. Thank you. Be safe. Have a great day.